if we want to know what's at the end of the universe, we should start at the beginning. There are many different ideas of how our universe began, but most accepted one is the Big Bang theory. The Big Bang theory was first proposed in 1920s, saying that the universe was once super small. From its tiny beginning, the universe stretched and expanded until it became as big as is it right now. According to the NASA, if we look at the universe 1 second after the Big Bang, we would most likely to see a 10 billion degrees sea of particles, such as neutrons, protons, electrons. That's really hot.
As everything expanded and took up more space, it all cooled down. Particles grouped together and formed atoms. These atoms gave birth to stars and galaxies and molecules, and eventually the universe was filled with all planets, people and lovable internet friends you have today. Our universe could be expanding and stretching, and might do so for a long time.
But is the Big Bang leading theory? Do we have any proof?
Well, around the same time when Big Bang theory was introduced, Edwin Hubble made a very interesting observation. He noticed that other galaxies were moving away from us in all directions. Not only that, but the farther apart galaxies from us were moving faster away. It should be that universe was still expanding. If things are moving apart, it stands to reason that they were once close together.
Since the Big Bang says that our early universe was a very hot place that eventually cooled down, then there should be leftover radiation.
Robert Wilson and Arno Penzias were the first to find radiation while they were building the radio receivers. We know that CMB radiation is not only very cold to absolute, in fact, but it also pretty uniform throughout the universe. The uniformity is why it makes sense that it all came from one place like the Big Bang.
But do we know how is our universe going to end? Cosmologist has three possible explanations for this. First is big freeze, big rip, and big crunch.
To understand these scenarios, imagine two objects representing galaxies. A short tight rubber band is holding them together, that is attractive force of the gravity. Meanwhile, two hooks are pulling them apart, that's the repulsive force expanding the universe. The outcome of the battle between these two opposing forces determines how the end of universe will play out. The big freeze scenario is what happens if the force pulling the objects apart is just strong enough to stretch the rubber band until it loses its elasticity.
The expansion wouldn't be able to accelerate anymore, but the universe will keep getting bigger.
Clusters of galaxies would separate. The objects within the galaxies like Sun, planets, solar system would move away from each other. Until galaxies dissolve into lonely objects floating separately in vast space, the light they emit would be red shifted to the long wavelengths with a very low faint energies, and the gas emitting from them would be too thin to create new stars. The universe will become darker and colder, approaching a frozen state also known as the Big Chill or the heat death of the universe. But what if the repulsive force is too strong that it stretches rubber band past its elastic limit and actually tears it? If the expansion of the universe continues to accelerate, then it will eventually overcome not only the gravitational forces tearing apart galaxies and solar system, but also electromagnetic, weak and strong nuclear forces which holds atoms and nuclei together. As the result, the matter that makes up the stars breaks into tiny pieces. Even atoms and subatomic particles would be destroyed, and thus the big rip. Big crunch corresponds to a possible future in which the force of gravity brings the universe expansion to a halt and then reverse it. Galaxies would start rushing towards each other, and they clump together, their gravitational pull will get even stronger. Stars too would huddle together and collide. Temperature would rise as the space would get tighter and tighter. The size of the universe would plummet until everything compressed into a small space that even atoms and subatomic particles would have to crunch together. The result would an incredibly dense, hot, compact universe, a lot like the state that preceded the Big Bang.
Could this tiny point of matter could explode in another Big Bang? Could the universe expand and contract over and over again, repeating its entire history? Well, that concept is called Big Bounce. As per the observation, we are heading towards the Big Freeze. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any feedback, please let us know in the comment section below. And do not forget to press the bell icon. Bye-bye, tata, hasta la vista. And now you can see the sea. This is beautiful sea. This is my place. This is...